so much of a pleasure to just sort of, you know, come up with things like different naming schemes for different races and cultures, or and I just spent so much time just reading, you know, myths and legends and histories and coming up with. I think, you know, this is what J.R.R. Tolkien did for pretty much all his life, inventing languages, inventing countries, and maybe telling you, you know, it was like he was writing an article about something that happened there, right? But in comparison with the world that exists in his head. Now, I'm not J.R.R. Tolkien, clearly. But it's still great fun. It's great fun for everyone. And if you're working in fantasy specifically, I think things like strong names and strong you know, systems of naming and the sort of the idea of a world beyond the book and characters and races having their own histories that are not necessarily described in the actual text but implied. It's a very, very, it's something that really makes whatever world you're building seem not random. No, and it's something that books set in the real world start off with as an advantage. It's something that you can overcome in speculative fiction with just real hard work. It's great fun, right? Yeah.